The supermarket Juniata in Philadelphia's north side is the kind of place where bananas are called rulo, beans are habichuelas, and pumpkins are cabucha.
Productos tropicales.
Jose Gomez is the Dominican-born owner of this business, also known as a bodega, warehouse in Spanish. He prides himself in offering products used in Latin cuisine. He says he left New York City 13 years ago to escape a saturated and very competitive grocery store market for Latinos. He settled in a neighborhood that was losing its mostly white residents, who fled as area factories closed their doors.
Latinos saw an opportunity and began to move there and began to purchase homes, to buy homes.
Pedro Rodriguez, director of human resources of the city of Philadelphia, says businesses like Juniata started to pop up in more places as the Latino population grew.
And as a result of that, is now the emergence of a vibrant business sector.
Business that is now an important part of the political influence of Latinos in the state.
With the growth of our economic sector in the Latino community, we can also contribute money to political campaigns and candidates, which also brings more renewed attention. We get invited to sit at the table, not as much as we would like, but we're beginning to break those ceilings now.
Rodriguez says Latino businesses were an important part of the coalition that helped current Mayor Jim Kenney, a Democrat, get elected last year after he faced a Latino candidate in the primaries. A study by the City University of New York, commissioned by CNN and Español, shows that some 900,000 Latinos live in Pennsylvania. Most of them are in Philadelphia and nearby counties. In 1990, only 225,000 Latinos called the Keystone State home. But their political participation is below the national average, even though Puerto Ricans, who are U.S. citizens by birth, make up the majority of Latinos in the state. According to the study, in 2012, only 45% of Latinos eligible to vote participated in the presidential election. And the same study projects that only 42% will vote this year.
The numbers are beginning to force many of us to accept the realities that we need to push forward, and then we need to translate a lot of those numbers into real votes.
That reality includes a growing diversity of the Latino community as immigrants from various countries arrive to the state.
New flavors are coming into
it. Edgardo Gomez is the chairman of the board of the Puerto Rican Workshop, a cultural and civic nonprofit organization. He sees the new arrivals as a new opportunity to grow the political reach of his community.
Everybody's contributing one way or another, so it becomes more a flavor, more mix. You got more options.
Gustavo Valdes, CNN, Philadelphia.